Unit 1, Part 2,
Episode 87.
I'm Sheila, also known as Sheila D37.
And I'm Wendy, also known as Penny Wenny.
Just a few reminders, we're having a knit-along for holiday knitting, and I'm sorry, I'm looking at my face, it's all angled, because I have a really bad pain.
She can only turn her head a certain way.
I must have slept on it wrong yesterday, because I realized I'm like, crooked. Sorry. So anyways, we have a holiday knit along for anything that's holiday theme related. Stockings, ornaments, oh, sugar Christmas gifts coming for teachers. Oh,
ornaments, anything that has your theme. It could be Kwanzaa, it could be Hanukkah,
Christmas, Festivus for the rest of us.
Whatever is your holiday.
But it can't just be a gift.
No, it has to have a theme to it.
It has to have a holiday theme on the knitted item.
The item has to be themed.
So,
I'm going to work on my advent calendar, maybe.
Oh, good. Maybe. That would be good.
I'll talk more about that later, because I'm in some kind of a knitting doldrum, and I need to get myself out of it.
I need to finish a project. And I'm working on it.
We have 1,070 members in our group.
Oh, great. I'm getting there to 1,200 almost. No, 1,100.
To 1,100.
Sorry.
I
was up early. Had to take my little guy to the lab, but some good news on that one later. So, I went away. Just a quick thing. I went away, and my father gave the boys iPod Touches for Christmas. He won't be here for Christmas, so he gave them to him early. This is Zachary's, and I wanted to... we were driving to a doctor's appointment last night, and Zachary was playing a bunch of these things. It's called voice memos. He's been having a field day on them. And I wanted to play one for you guys because I thought it was a riot. Tells you what, you don't think your kids are paying attention.
But they are.
They are. So I'm going to try this. And
knit one, heart two, and we're going to show you a dance, because we sure dance all the time on this show.
So when I first started listening to this, I'm like, oh my god, that's so funny. I hope you guys heard it. It's Zachary trying to introduce himself as Knit One Heart Two and gets it wrong completely. But I just thought it was funny because he has it a couple of times doing it.
Yeah.
Where he introduces himself as Knit One Heart Two in various different forms, whether it's Knit One, Knit Two Heart, whatever.
Knit Heart One Two.
But it just tells you that they do pick up on a
and
lot
I love
of
it that he introduces himself as that, and then he's going to show you a dance.
Yes. That would be my little guy. That was brought to you by my little guy.
So cute.
Yeah, it's been really good. It's basically a mini iPad. A mini iPad.
A mini. It's like an iPhone without the phone.
Exactly. And they've been having a lot of fun with it. And it keeps them out of my hair sometimes when we have doctor's appointments.
So that's good.
So we just have to upload music for them now. And Cam's sister, who was watching the boys, bought shirts for them someplace that has headphones attached. That headphone over there?
Yeah, that's neat.
Yeah, the black one, which is what Zachary needs. He can't wear regular earbud phones.
Right, he needs the big ones.
He needs the big ones, and so that's been working out well. But that's my little interlude for this morning. So we'll get right on to projects, and I'm really excited because, yeah, this is still what I'm working on. But I'm getting there. I think 2 repeats before I actually start to decrease for the toe. And I was at with my friend last night who's also doing the Flutterbys. And she picked up my finish. She's doing 2 at a time, toe up.
Yeah.
And she picked up mine. She goes, what yarn is this? This is so much heavier. I said, it's the same yarn. We're both using Blue Moon. We're both using the same size needle. I'm just a tighter knitter than she is, and it's a little denser. And I'm going to be using just probably about every bit of this, because this is all I have left.
You're very close to being done.
That's all I have left. I was hoping I could get And I still might be able to get one more thing out of this, meaning a little added extra for the person who these are going to. And I'm not going to say it just in case I can't, but...
Bless you. Do you want a Kleenex?
No, I'm okay, I think. That kind of snuck up on me. So, unfortunately, this is all I'm working on. I am working tonight and tomorrow. I tried knitting on the plane with this.
Yeah.
We flew Southwest, which means you don't have assigned seats. And going down, I was in the middle with two different people on either side of me.
Yeah.
So you sit like this so that you don't interrupt anyone.
Yeah.
Actually, the first flight down, I was on the window, but I still had somebody different than me. The second flight, because we had a connecting flight, I was in the middle. And I tried knitting and actually spoke, brought up a conversation with one of the guys. Because he goes, can you knit me a hat before I land? I'm like, yeah, no.
Do you have $300?
Well, and then he's like, you know, then he was asking about the pattern. He goes, does the yarn do that or do you do that? I said, I do. And I kind of showed him briefly. He was actually quite fascinated. He's a guy.
Yeah.
He doesn't know. Not saying that all guys don't, but he's a guy whose wife probably doesn't knit.
Yeah.
And obviously he doesn't knit. But I came off the plane, like, just aching. My arms and my hands were just aching because I was stiff. So on the flight back, I didn't even bother packing this. I packed it in my suitcase. I'm not even going to bother. Because it's really hard when you're trying to, if it was just plain old knitting, I could probably put it down and knit and not worry about it. But it wasn't. So I didn't get much knitting done. And then we were in Vegas and no knitting was done in Vegas. And I'll save this part for my heartbreak. But so I'm almost done. It comes down to this fact that I'm almost done. Cool. And I'm hoping to finish this tonight.
So is that it?
Yes.
That's it for you. All right.
That's it for me. Hopefully I'll have something different next week.
Well, I'll start out with the one that I didn't work on, which I really have to work on, and I've just been a total slacker. Little baddie is still at the same point it's been. Haven't done anything on it because I've just been sidetracked. I should really work on it. I don't know why I haven't. I think because I'm lazy. So yeah, that's Little Batty out of Socks That Rock Lightweight in the Rookie colorway on US 6 4mm needles. It's a pattern that I'm working on that I want to put up for sale someday if I ever get it done. So the other thing that I didn't work on that I didn't even bother to bring with me is my Shetland triangle. I seriously just need to knit like one more repeat and then do the edging. And it's just fallen by the wayside, so I didn't even bother to bring that by. But that's Shetland Triangle by Evelyn Clark, and I'm knitting it in Great Adirondack Lolita in the antique colorway on US 7 needles. And like I said, it's basically done. I just need to finish it. I just haven't been working on it. I did do a little bit on these since I saw you last. These are the Aquaphobia Socks by Crystal Flanagan. It's a free pattern on Ravelry, and they are, and I'm in the middle of a sock, hold on a second. And they are in the Into the World Pooling Sock Yarn, the Muse colorway. What have I just done here? I just dropped a stitch. Which is coming out really pretty. I've knit the Aquaphobia sock before. There, now I'm not in the middle of a sock. I've knit this pattern before. It's really wonderful for pooling yarn because it's basically Eye of Partridge on the front of the sock. So that's what it looks like.
Pretty.
Yep, I'm doing them toe up, two at a time. You can see the difference. This is the back, and it's kind of like stripey in the colors, but when you do the slip stitch, it blends it more.
Yeah.
And it was really interesting. For the longest time, they were almost identical. They've moved away from each other a little bit. They're curly because the slip stitch side is shorter than the back.
How many stitches is that?
This is 72.
Okay.
Because they curl.
To account for the pulling. Yeah.
For the pulling in. Yes. And I am really just. Oops! I just kicked the table. I'm almost at the point where I need to do the slip stitch heel, and I am going to video a tutorial. I thought I would do it earlier, but the reason I didn't is because I swatched
You doing a short row heel on that?
Yes. Okay. So I'm going to do the short row heel. Did I say slip stitch?
Yeah, you did. I wasn't sure.
I didn't mean slip stitch. I mean short row. I'm going to do a tutorial for Wendy Johnson's sock, which is the one that I use, just to show you. So anyway, I was going to do that this weekend because I recorded on Friday. And I think on Sunday night or Monday morning, I used my hand spun from Spinner's Hill to swatch for the Skipper D sweater. And it kind of kept going.
It went from a swatch to a sweater.
So this is the body of the Skipper D sweater. And I'm sorry that it's getting some. There we go. Blocked the light with it. We have a little lighting issue today, but we
didn't do our typical studio setup.
I'm trying to block the light with my sweater, but there you can get an idea. It's stripey. It's a lot bigger than it looks because it's on a cable, and you can see I've separated for the arm. So this is the.
Is it a cardigan?
It's a cardigan. So this is up to here.
Cool.
And so that's the body, and then I also did a sleeve. These are 3/4 length sleeves. Oops, I don't have to get up to show you that. They go to here. So they'll be right about there. You can see. And the sleeve has this nice cable detail on it, which you can kind of see. And I love it. It's coming out great. I think it's going to be really comfy.
Mm.
And cozy. So this total took 4 skeins of yarn.
Which is roughly how many yards each?
That was about 700 yards total. And I have another 200 yards, another 300 yards. So I have about 1,000 yards done. So as we started this morning, I cast on for the second sleeve. And I have enough yarn to do the second sleeve, and I'll need to spin some more. So this yarn I actually finished 2 nights ago. I'm at the point where I've used up all my, I have to spin more. Last night I spun for a couple hours, so.
Now, I'm not a spinner, and I have not knit sweaters, but is that the proper way of doing things?
No.
No, I didn't think so.
Well, I mean, there's no proper way to do it.
Right.
Diane, my friend Diane, don't turn your head towards me.
I didn't, I just moved.
My friend Diane took me to task because the way that she did it. Is when she spins for a sweater, she spins 9 bobbins of singles. Single, 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 single. 9 bobbins. And then she takes the first, and she has numbers on her bobbins. Okay. So she puts the first and the, like, 5th and the 9th bobbin, and she plies those together. And then the 2nd and the 4th and the, you know, and she does them so that they're, she tries to put stuff from the beginning, the middle, and the end together to get a more consistent yarn.
You don't care.
I guess I don't. So far, I mean, if you look on my project page, you will see that the skeins that I have been doing have either been 150 yards or 175 yards, like on the nose. This last one that I did, they were both 150 yards.
Oh, wow.
So I think my yarn is pretty consistent. If you look at the sweater, it's pretty consistent. There's not a lot of thick and thin on it.
No, it looks good in it.
It looks like regular yarn. So I think I do periodically I know other spinners spin as they go. I know I'm not the only one who does it. It's just not the most, for my first sweater, I probably shouldn't have done it this way, but whatever. Whatever. I'm too lazy to do it that way. And I only have 6, I only have 8 bobbins. I don't have 9, so I can't really do 9 all at once. Right. So, I'm just spinning as I go, and I do periodically take my single that's on the wheel, and I triple it, and I let it spin up a little bit in my hand to see if it's about the thickness that I want, and that seems to have been keeping me on the track. And the thing about worsted weight yarn is worsted weight singles for 3-ply worsted weight are kind of my default yarn. And that's what I like to spin. So I'm that's what I often spin. So I think that's like, I'm used to spinning that weight. I think if I was trying to do a fingering weight sweater or a bulky weight sweater or lace weight, I would have a more of an issue. But this is the yarn that I'm used to spinning. So I have, this is about 150 yards. You can see it on here. And that's how much I have of the next sleeve. And yeah, I did not know I was going to start knitting the sweater. I was just going to swatch to see if I was in the ballpark. And I don't know what
things happen.
It just kept going because I'll tell you what, I really like knitting with my hand spun. I feel like the king of the world when I'm knitting with my hand spun. It's really kind of pulled me out of my knitting doldrums because I feel like, you know, I don't know. I feel like Superwoman. I want to go around and tell everybody I made this sweater from fluff. Like,
yeah.
You see this? This was fluff, and I made it into a garment.
Sheep to sweater type of deal.
Yeah, you know, well, although we will, somebody said they did sheep to sweater. I can't remember where I read this, and the person that took, somebody in the comments took them to task, because real sheep to sweater would be if you sheared it off the sheep right. and washed it yourself and carded it yourself, and yeah, I don't
fiber think. To sweater.
So I went from prepared fiber to sweater, fluff yeah. to sweater. And it makes me, I don't know why, but it makes me feel like I did something.
Good.
More so than, I mean, more so
more
than
so
just
than
knitting
just
it.
Picking up a skein of yarn and knitting.
And I also like the fact that nobody else in the world is going to have a sweater that looks like this. Because
true.
It's my yarn and it's
and
unique.
Even if it's the same colored yarn, it wouldn't look
it
the same.
It still wouldn't look the yeah. same. Yeah. So that makes me feel like, I don't know, like Superwoman. So yeah, here's my Superwoman sweater. I think that's yeah. what I'm going to call it. I'm enjoying it. I had a hard time understanding the cable on the sleeve. There was one stitch that I was not familiar with that was make four stitches out of one, and it was done in a way that I've never done it before to make it look like a cable. And I couldn't find a tutorial for it online, and I did finally figure out a way that looks good, but I need to contact the designer to make sure that I did it right. So just because it was unclear to me, and I figure if it was unclear to me, it might be unclear to other
everyone,
people because
yeah.
I've been knitting a long time, and I seriously, it took me like an hour to figure it out. But once I figured out the stitch, and also I had to figure out that the sweater cable is, it doesn't have a break in it. It's very... It took me a minute to figure where I had to swap stitches back onto the other needles and in order to make it go all the way around without a break in it.
Oh.
It's, what is the word for that? Continuous. The cable is continuous. So on a couple of rows, you need to take stitches and swap them back onto the other needle and don't knit them the first time around. And it was hard for me to understand that, but I did... figure that out. That didn't take as long as figuring out how to do that stitch. I tried that stitch about 7 different ways before I found one that looked right. Hopefully I don't even care anymore. Oh, I'm going to do it that way for the rest of the sweater, but
right.
I'm just going to get in touch with the designer in case she wants to make it clearer. So
that's good.
Yeah.
On to finished objects. I don't have any.
And I don't have any finished objects either. Write Your Date?
No,
we just did that. Whirlwind Romance.
That's what I was thinking of.
My Whirlwind Romance is always the sweater. I have 2 bobbins full of singles towards the next 300 yards. So I have to spin 1 more bobbin full and then ply, and I'll have another 300 yards of this. And I think I'm only going to need 300 or 400 more yards of it, so that might be enough to finish the sweater. And I have plenty of fluff, fiber. I still have a ton of fiber left. So because the spinner's hill, because of the way it's prepped, it's very the yarn is thick, but it's lofty. It's not dense. Do you know what I mean?
Yep.
So I'm not using a lot of the fiber to get the thickness that I want.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to have a little bit left over. But then, and then the Kvyat is still on the Sidekick. I didn't work on it at all because once I started knitting the sweater, I want this to be done before Christmas. I really want it to be done before next week, but I don't know if that's going to happen. Because now that this is knitting up so cool, I have another sweater's worth of yarn that I got from Rachel at Diabolical. that I'm going to do in a different way to be really crazy and stripey. And now I totally want to start spinning that because it's been so fun doing this. So
oh, good.
So that's it for Whirlwind Romance. Nothing to show.
Future dates. I've been talking about this, and my brother's birthday was actually yesterday, and I didn't do anything for it yet, but I was away. I'm going to be knitting him slippers. And I think I should have enough yarn. I have like 4 or 5 skeins of this. This is old wool that somebody gave me. I mean, really old wool. You can tell by the label.
Yeah.
Edelweiss wool. My friend Tara, I was out with last night, she gave this to me. Her husband's grandmother, I think?
Yeah.
Gave it to her. And this is wool. And
the big ragu.
Yeah.
Sorry.
It's bulky wool. It doesn't have very much yardage to it by the looks of it, but I have a bunch. And I think what I'll do, this isn't going to be enough for the cuff. I'll have to find some other wool, but I'm going to use this for the base of the slipper. I'm going to do the Fiber Trends clog. This is for my brother, and I'll put a sole on it. But I'll probably start this weekend because I literally have 2 more repeats to before I start decreasing the toe on this sock. So hopefully, who knows, I might even have a finished pair of slippers.
Yeah, because that goes fast.
They do go fast, but I this is just going to be one strand because it's a bulky wool. So when it typically calls for 2 strands of Cascade 220 held together. And I think that would be about the same.
I think so too.
And so this will felt nicely. And I'll pick a contrasting color for the top, but that's what I'm going to be casting on next. And then I think after that, I'm going to try a shawl.
Good.
I need to get out of the sock rut, and by then, I might be done with school.
Yeah, I know. That'll be awesome.
And then I'll be, like, kind of in a job, but not really, because I won't be getting paid for it.
Sort of a job, because it's still a job.
Yeah, it'll get me the experience without getting paid.
Yeah.
Kind of stinks.
An internship.
Yeah.
So my future date, I'm definitely going to move on to something lace weight because I need to get my knitting mojo back and it needs to be something that is exciting to me. I'm really into this sweater night right now, but this is going to be done pretty quick because I basically started that on, I think I really started knitting on it on Monday night. That's when I got past the ribbing on the bottom of the body. And I had it, so that's Monday. By Thursday night, I had the body and the sleeve done. And that's not even knitting on it, like, that's only knitting on it after dinner. So it's fast. Because the yoke is going to take longer because it has that same cable across it. But I need something that's more intricate. So I have 3 ideas that I'm going to do. That I'm going to choose from. I'm not going to do all 3. I have the yarn that I picked out. I have some Madeline Tosh yarn, and I think it's the wheat colorway for Bee Fields by Ann Hansen, which is a shawl pattern. It's $9 on Ravelry. It's a huge shawl, and it has a bee theme. And I got like this honey-colored Madeline Tosh. Ooh. It's really pretty. So I've had that for 2 years. 2 or 3 years sitting in the stash. The next idea is I might instead do the shipwreck shawl, which is from Nitty.
Oh, yeah.
It's a free pattern, and I have some yarn from Spirit Trail Fiberworks that I got.
Would you do the beads or no beads?
I think I would do the beads just because I've never done beads before, but I have to see how the beads are.
You have to string them.
You have to string them. I don't think I would string them. I think I would use the crochet method. So, because there's no way I'm going to string beads and then, no. I've done that before and it's a nightmare.
Yeah.
So, but I could easily do the crochet over the thing. It's similar. It would just have a slightly different look. So I have that and I have lace weight yarn from Spirit Trail Fiberworks that I got 2 or 3 Rhinebecks ago for that. Or I might do the Ivy Brambles Seashell Shawl, which is available for $6 on Ravelry. And it's 100% silk. And I have this gorgeous silver silk. It's a silver gray, pure silk that I got from Blue Moon Fiber Arts. And I'm kind of leaning towards that.
When did you get that? Before I knew you?
No, it was a couple of years ago at Stitches.
Oh,
right. You were not with me when I bought it.
No, I've never been to Stitches.
I own all of these patterns. I own Bee Fields. I own Ivy Brambles and the Nitty pattern I have downloaded. It's free. So, and I have the yarn for each of these projects waiting that's like earmarked for that project. So the thing is to just choose it. I'm kind of tempted by the shipwreck shawl, but I'm kind of, because I've never done a circular shawl before, but then I'm kind of like, I don't know, it might get kind of boring once you get past the center because it's all the same thing. And then you're just putting the beads on and I don't know. And then the seashell shawl, I just think that's going to be really gorgeous. But I don't know about knitting with pure silk.
Have you touched it?
Yes, okay. I touched the skein. It's the shiny, smooth kind. It's not it's not like this. Feel this. This is
the one that Steve made.
Steve made, and this is...
See, this doesn't bother me.
I don't like to touch it with my fingers.
See, this doesn't bother me at all.
It feels chalky to me. I don't know. Mm. I like the way I wear it. I just don't like to touch it with my hands. Sorry, Steve. I just don't. So, yeah. So, I got to figure that out. But if I'll, you know, post in the thread if you've knit any of these shawls and you can recommend them to help me decide. I won't be casting it on for the next couple of weeks. But Bee Fields Shipwreck Shawl, Ivy Bramble Seashell Shawl. I'm leaning towards the seashell shawl. I think that'll be fast and easy. So, and that's it for my future dates.
Crushes and heartbreaks. So, I have a couple. My husband and I went to Vegas. We had a really good time. We flew in on Wednesday. We stayed at Excalibur. We walked the Strip, which has gotten a lot bigger in the last 10 years, let me tell you. Because that was when the last time we went. And came in and collapsed. I felt bad because we came in... We flew in, we got there to like 4 or 5, I don't remember, and we walked the Strip, we had dinner, and it was nice, and when we had dinner, we were able to watch, we were people watching.
Yeah.
And you couldn't help but it was just so funny watching people. Vegas is a great place to watch people.
I bet.
From the natives to the not. Everybody, apparently it's legal to walk around with open, you know, alcohol beverages.
Oh, yeah?
Which, in Massachusetts, it's not.
No.
So people were walking with these huge things of mixed drinks or different shapes. They had shapes of the the Eiffel Tower of Paris.
That's weird.
Oh, my God. Well, because people can walk around with it, it's just, oh, my God, it was so funny watching them. And Cam and I are looking, my husband and I are looking at them like, seriously, you're going to drink all that? I mean, it's just ridiculous. But, you know, I'm not much of a drinker anyway. So we get back to the hotel, and I see, he's like, come on, let's gamble it. And I'm not a gambler. And I said, no, I want to just, you know, go upstairs and rest. My feet are killing me. I'll set the alarm for an hour. I know going upstairs, I wasn't coming back. My husband knew it, too. He's like, yes, set your alarm for an hour, my ass. He came up, and I was sleeping. The reason was is because we ended up taking a car to L.A. to visit his family. The heartbreak in this is we go to rent the car. My husband's birthday was in October. His license expired. They don't send out renewals anymore.
Not in Massachusetts.
Not anymore.
So you're expected to just know.
And so we had an issue with renting the car because he was the one who booked it. So then we had to go to the credit card agency because he booked it through Miles.
Yeah.
Points to make sure that they would put my name on it so that they would get paid. So it ended up, we rented the car. We rented a full-size car, Crown Vic. I felt like a 70-year-old lady driving behind this huge car.
Oh, my God.
Let me tell you, though. It
or like a detective in New York in the 70s.
Good thing was it was a 2011. It was fairly new. But still, I'm like, oh, my gosh, Cam. We went to L.A. We had a good time. I don't speak any of my husband's language, and they don't speak English. So at one point, I said to my husband, it would have been better off if I just stayed in Vegas.
I know. You could have, like,
hung by the pool. But we had a good time, but it was funny with the Crown Vic and his license. So I drove. That was part of the other reason I didn't get to knit.
Yeah, because you were driving.
Yeah, I would have knit while he was driving. It was a 4-hour ride to LA and a 4-hour ride back, which wasn't a problem. It's funny because we're together, you know, we've been together for 20 years. You wouldn't think we had a lot to talk about. But we did. We talked about everything, which was really, really nice. Yeah. You know, it makes me feel good that we still have a strong relationship. You know what I mean?
That's how I felt when I went away on my anniversary trip. When you have kids, you start to not have the time to just have chatting, you know? Like, you're chatting about household stuff.
Right, we didn't always talk about the kids. We were talking about certain songs or you know, the election or family or whatever. We were just talking about everything, so it was great. And on the ride back, we were talking about family and stuff, obviously, his family. And so we had a good time. Vegas was good, and then we stayed a few more days. We saw a show. The comedian was good about the show. That's about all I can say. It was a typical Vegas show, but that way it was, you know, topless.
Yeah.
And I felt bad for those women walking around topless. I'm not against it in any way or form.
I guess it just feels like there must be some more dignified way to make your money.
I mean, it wasn't a topless bar. It was a
review.
Yeah, it was a burlesque show. Right. It was a nice show. They did it well. It wasn't all topless, but I don't know. I said to my husband, I'm like, the comedian was much better in my eyes, and he was hilarious. He made a few good points about Vegas that my husband and I were just laughing our butts off. I had tears coming down my eyes. He was really good. He was lewd. He used a lot of swear words.
Yeah.
Words that I wouldn't use on a normal basis. Some words that even make you cringe when you hear them. Again, I'm not a prude in any sort of the way, but you don't hear those words often. So we had a good time. So that was our crush and heartbreak. We came home. I don't think my sister-in-law will be offering to babysit anytime soon.
Oh, did they burn her? Well, she had that incident.
There was an incident that I'm actually allowed not to tell because my oldest is kind of embarrassed. Not embarrassed. He went somewhere where he shouldn't have. He broke the number one rule that if you get separated from your party, you're supposed to stay where you last saw them. So he broke that rule.
Panic ensued.
Yes, panic ensued. I don't think it was because of that so much as, let's see, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. 5 days with the kids when you are not used to that is very overwhelming.
I think so.
You know, obviously my brother could have handled it better because he's got kids, so to speak.
Yeah, he's used to it.
Yeah, Monica, she picked us up, brought us home. We gave her what we got her, which was a nice leather purse, pocketbook, and she took off.
She was like, I'm free of this.
Kim's like, do you think we scared her? I said, no, I'm sure she just wanted to get back to her place.
To her life, to her things.
Well,
where there were no children.
Just to download. I mean, it was just like us being away. I mean, it was good to be able to, you know, come home early. We came home at about 4 o'clock on Sunday. I didn't have school. Kids didn't have school on Monday. Kim had work. We had a good time. You know, the heartbreak was the driver's license. I had to drive everywhere. But that's okay. I'm okay with that. And the good thing was, sometimes when I drive, I get drowsy, but I didn't.
Awesome.
You know, the conversation was lively enough. And again, you're together with 20 years with somebody that if there's silence, it's not awkward silence. Hopefully by now it's not. But I just didn't get to knit. I was hoping to finish the sock. I didn't. So that's basically my crushes and heartbreak. School is going well. Crush. Zachary had labs today. And this is a lab that I'm familiar with. They know me. So I went and told the woman who referred me to the school anyways, telling her that I'm in the middle of a class and I talked to somebody. So I may already have my externship, internship, however you want to call it, lined up for next year.
So that's great.
Yes, because as soon as I finish the externship and get a job, then it will be better.
Yes. Excellent.
Yeah.
So that's really good.
Yeah. It is really good news, and, you know, it's another little funny thing. So I missed 2 days of school last week. I got the notes from people.
Yeah.
One of them I didn't really study for, and I think I got an 85, 88, which I'm like, all right, I can do this. You know, it's my own fault I didn't study for. Well, the other one I didn't really study for, I just read it real quick, got a 96, which I'm excited for. But I feel bad because there are people who are studying for it all day and they didn't do as good as me.
Well, you're just smarter than them.
Well, it was EKG stuff. It was stuff that kind of made sense to me.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It, you know, some of the stuff makes sense because I've lived it.
Yeah.
Not learned it, but lived it. And, you know, living it is...
Yeah, I think that I personally would do really well in an EKG class.
Yeah, so our EKG labs are taking EKGs on each other.
Oh, cool.
So, you know, and if you've ever had an EKG, you have to strip naked and wear a johnny.
Yeah.
But we don't do that,
obviously. Well, you strip naked to the waist.
Waist, right. We don't do that, obviously.
Yeah.
But so we roll up our shirts and kind of tuck them underneath our bras. And it's funny, there's quite a few people who are overweight and we're just all comfortable with each other. You know, we're going about our business with the lab and we're joking about everything, our relationships.
Yeah.
And the teacher's just looking at us. I'm like, oh my God, he must think we're insane.
I'm sure it's the same with every class.
I know, but it's just
there's
fun.
A camaraderie when you have
there really
to
is.
Do that stuff, and it's all different. Law school was like that. So
it was fun. We had a good
law
time
school.
Yesterday.
It was like being in boot camp together. You're just like, you know, you're all thrown in, and you're all like dealing with this strange stuff.
Right.
And yeah.
So it was fun. That's my crushes and heartbreaks.
Let's see. Mine. Well, first of all, my crush is my friends. I'm giving a shout out to Amy, Lori, MJ, and Melissa. I've been having kind of a bad week for a couple of reasons, but they were cheering me up on texting.
How come I don't know about this? I mean, besides the fact that
you
weren't now.
Yeah. Oh, about because you've been gone. I didn't talk to you yet this week.
Now I'm all like.
No, I know, and a part of it is I'm feeling down on myself because I'm not working, and I think it's because you're in school and you have all your new friends, and you have all your new job opportunities coming up, and you're learning all your new stuff, and I'm starting to feel bad, like I'm the only one that I know that doesn't have a job, and maybe I should go back to work, only I just really don't want to go back to work.
In all honesty, I wouldn't if I didn't have to.
I know, and I know I should be grateful that, you know, my husband is doing well enough that I can stay at home and not have to worry about things, and, you know, and it is really good to have somebody at home to take the kids to all their stuff, so, you know, I don't know, I'm just down on myself this week, and a part of it is that, and a part of it is that I was sick for so long. I haven't been able to go to the gym. And then I had company in my house, which was great. I love having my mom. But, you know, there's a lot of stuff that I like screwed around with my mom and went shopping and had a good time. And I didn't take care of business that I should be taking care of and been slacking off on doing designing. So that's making me feel like I'm like not, I don't know. Speaking of my mom who just called, I love hanging out with my mom, but I didn't get a lot of my stuff done. So I've just been feeling kind of, just bad about myself. I need to get back to the gym. I need to get my stuff done. I need to work more on getting some designs done. And I do have some things out for test right now. So at least I'm taking care of that business. And, I've just been depressed, and I think a part of it also might be the time change. Mm. So I amped up my vitamin D because I get low vitamin D in the winter. It can cause seasonal affective disorder.
Yeah.
So I don't really have seasonal affective disorder, but I do have a vitamin D deficiency in the winter. And I take vitamin D supplement anyway because I always have a vitamin D deficiency, but it gets worse in the winter. So I amped it up to 5,000 milligrams. So hopefully that's going to make me feel better. But MJ and Amy and Lori and Melissa were cheering me up yesterday. Yesterday I was feeling pretty bad. And I tried to talk to you. But, you know, it's been, you know, kind of...
It's tough being at school.
You're at school.
I'm out of the house from 8 to 2 every day. I didn't move.
I know. Why did it...
I don't know, but I didn't move. It's been tough being out of the house 8 to 2 every day except for Friday. And then Friday, it's catch-up day.
Yeah. And, you know, I don't like to call you during the day because I know, like, you're at school. And then I never want to call you too early in the afternoon because I can never remember if you might have worked. I don't want to wake you up.
Hint,
but
My work schedule is Monday, Friday, Saturday.
So Monday, Friday, Saturday. Okay, so I can just
yeah.
not call you on Tuesday. Is that right?
Pretty much.
Okay. Well, all right.
But yesterday happened to be extremely circumstances because Zachary had an appointment.
I was a little worried when I didn't hear back from you.
Max was supposed to have soccer, which we missed, and he was pissed.
Yeah.
It just wasn't a good day.
It was not a good day. So, yeah, I was just having down. But they were, we've all gotten, I don't know if you've on it, but there's this thing on the internet called Whims, or I guess you can get it on your phone.
No, but I've been seeing you guys.
And you can make little signs or whatever. And, so they were cheering me up with their craziness. And also what really cheered me up is that the new Twist Collective came out, and there's a sweater pattern called Picard.
Oh, is it?
And I said I was going to knit it with one arm. So anyway, as a result of this craziness, I have a new phrase that I'm going to share with you that Melissa inspired, and it's called Soup for Christmas.
Okay.
And it means you can't afford something. So you'll say, like, ooh, that sweater's gorgeous, but it's $70, so soup for Christmas. Because Melissa made a joke that she would only be able to give cans of soup for Christmas presents. Sorry, Melissa, but I think that is so funny. So I'm trying to, like, spread it around because I think it should be, like, a new saying, like, awesome sauce, soup for Christmas. Yeah.
Soup for Christmas.
So that's my crush because those guys really cheered me up and... even though they all work. I was like, everyone's like, yeah, I gotta go to work. I'm like, not me, because I do nothing. But the other big thing that's been getting me down is that I have a dog that we've had for 3 years. I think 3 years. It's been a while.
Wow.
And he started biting people about a year after we got him from fear aggression. We have tried intensive private training. We have tried... training on our own with cognitive behavioral stuff that we were taught. We have put him on doggy Prozac. And just like we have tried everything that we can do. And my vet was right. You can't fix it. It's getting worse.
Is it?
It is. It's getting worse. I mean, it's just like it just gets worse. We have to have him put down.
He bit me.
Yeah. He's bit my son twice. He gets crazy when he's afraid, and he bites. And now anything that upsets him or scares him, he bites. That's his go-to thing. And the vet says it's some dogs just have this trigger in their brain that goes off, but the problem is once they start it, it's really hard to get rid of. So she gave me the prescription for doggy Prozac, but she said she's had two dogs that went like this, that were rescue dogs, and both of them ended up having to be put down for it because it's too dangerous to own a dog that might hurt somebody.
Right.
So we've been talking about it with the kids, but I think we need to have him put down in the next couple of weeks. So it's just that is preying on my mind too, because he's perfectly healthy. And aside from the fact that he bites people randomly, mostly strangers, he doesn't bite us that much. That may sound
that much.
Well, I mean, Jack has a habit of like jumping onto the couch and scaring him. And if he's too close to Skippy, Skippy might nip him. He's never broken anybody's skin, but he will go after people who are strangers. And
yeah, you can't.
I don't want him to hurt the kids either. It's just he has to be put down. It just makes me feel like crap.
No, I know.
So, yeah. So that's my heartbreak having to do that. And I don't know. I might do it next week. We've been putting it off. We've known for like 2 weeks now that we have to do it, and just nobody wants to do it.
Next week's Thanksgiving.
I know, but I don't know. I don't know what to do. I think we're going to get a different dog after.
Oh, okay.
Not right now, but like after Christmas. I don't want to try to get a dog around Christmas because that's too crazy.
Mm.
Sometime in January, February, if we can find one. I think we're going to get a puppy.
Yeah, start from fresh.
I know this sounds awful, but I think we're going to try to get a dog from a reputable breeder that we know the parentage of.
Right, because you've already had a bad experience.
I just cannot go through this again. My kids can't go through this again. Right. So, I don't know.
Well, if you need help next week, let me know.
Yeah, I know. I don't know. I just can't even deal
with it. I
know,
but...
Yeah, that's what's going on. This 2012 has been a crummy year for me. Whenever I have a bad year, you have a good year.
Let's, the opposite. Let's hopefully next year will be, you know, middle of the road.
Yeah, both have a good year. So, yeah, that's my crushes and heartbreaks. And baubles and bling.
I am due for a Blue Moon Fiber
Arts. Where is it? I thought
no,
you
not until the end of it. No, I already got the other one from September. I'm due for one at the end of this month. And this will be our last shipment, and I will be so sad.
I know. You will be. Because you love that.
I love Blue Moon.
So it's Into the World time again.
Pretty colors.
I love this. This is so beautiful.
Really pretty colors.
It's just gorgeous. I love it so much, I can't even tell you.
What's the name of it?
It's called, I don't even know if I can pronounce this, Irohamamiji. And it is from a scene in nature, obviously, with lots of foliage.
I get Google Translate on my iPad.
Iroha Momiji. I don't even know if that's how you say it. But it is these beautiful fall leaf colors. And I am really, I love it because it's the opposite of teal blue, which a lot of the other inspiration photos had similar colors in them. And it actually inspired Chris from Into the World to institute a club rule that if every single winning inspiration photo has the same colors in it, she reserves the right to change.
Irohamamiji.
Is that
how it's... Irohamamiji.
Well, oh, wait a minute. No, Momiji. This is English to English, so that's not necessarily.
So this is...
Irohamamiji.
Let me try. I bet you.
Irohamamiji.
It looks like it might be Japanese.
I don't know. I bet if you. What? That was crazy! Yeah, I don't think that's how you pronounce it.
Sorry! It's like a 12 letter word. It tends to be
a. It sounds like a sentence!
That was sorry. Crazy.
This is Corriedale, the basis.
Irohamamiji.
I think it's Irohamamiji. Irohamamiji is how I'm saying it. And
Chris, if you're watching it, let us know how to pronounce it.
Yeah, if you know how to pronounce this, let me know. Maybe Chris will too, like, since she definitely picked this inspiration. Corriedale base, love it. I think I might buy the coordinates. They're going on sale, I believe, on December 1st, but I'm not 100% sure. I would get this bright red as a coordinate.
Now,
so,
when you got the bright red, would you spin them separately and then ply them together? Is that how
I would do one ply of the solid and one ply of the color.
Okay.
Because I think that would be really pretty. Mm. But yeah, this is going to be awesome. I don't know what I'm going to make out of it, but I just love it. And I know some people aren't big fans of the colors, but I am. I love it. It reminds me of...
Now, was there a theme? Like what?
Well, this year, this current go-around, the last 4 months were inspirations from nature.
Oh, okay.
So there were pictures of natural wonders. That's why we had so much teal, because so many of them, I mean, when
water,
you're going to go from nature, water, sky, it's all blue.
it's all blue.
You know, blue, brown, green, those are the colors you're going to get. The next iteration is, there's a thread for it right now. If you're in the group and you want to participate, you can post a picture of, it's a painting that inspires you.
Oh.
So I was going to do it, but I was lazy. It's such a pain to upload things to Flickr and then link to them. I was like, whatever.
Okay.
Whatever. So, yeah. But that's my club for this month. I have two bumps of that because I have a double dose. I need to catch up on some of that. I was talking to my friend Diane, and I could totally mix together all of the last three clubs that have that teal in it into one to make a sweater if I wanted to, which is intriguing about how I would blend that. So I don't know. Maybe I'll think about it. So that's it for Baubles and Bling. I don't have anything else.
Gossip and innuendo. I'm trying to think what I have. Thanksgiving's coming up next week. Oh, yeah. Thanksgiving's coming up next week. You still want to record on Friday?
Oh, yeah.
We'd have the kids.
Well, and I don't know. I'm supposed to go somewhere on Friday.
We'll talk about it.
Yeah.
Maybe we can just take the week off.
Well, I don't know. I might still record just because I can. And you could record, and we could do two
separate. We'll
see.
We'll see what it
We'll
works
figure
out.
It out. I don't know. I have to figure out. I'm supposed to go over to a friend's house. I mean, we might be able to record first thing in the morning, and then I could come home. I won't have my kids. It would just be your kids.
My kids are good.
Yeah.
Not that you guys have, but mine are a little bit older, like...
Yeah, and my kids would be with my husband, and then I can go over to my friend's house in the afternoon.
Cam has to
Something
work.
Will get recorded next Friday, just don't know what it's going to be. We'll figure it out.
My husband always works the day after Thanksgiving, so...
So he won't be home.
Because he works in a bank.
The other gossip and innuendo, my String of Pearls hat testnet is going on. Thank you to the people that are doing it for me. A couple people had to drop out, so I'm going to ask for a few more volunteers. It's a really short project. It should take most people only a couple of days to finish because it's a hat. So I'll be soliciting a few more people to help out with that. And the short row heel tutorial, I'm definitely going to film it this weekend. Excuse me. I don't have any plans. So, and my socks are right at the point where I'm going to do it, so I will do that. Spa. Which is a spinning
retreat, right?
Retreat weekend in Freeport, Maine. I mentioned it last week. It is going to be during the first weekend in February. And I think it's from like the 1 through 3rd or the 3rd through 5th or something like that. It's the first weekend in February, whatever that is. And it is in Freeport, Maine. And I don't know where you can find information about it, but I will try to find out. But I am thinking I might treat myself to that this year.
Oh,
I have
nice.
To ask. My husband, what he thinks. And the last thing I wanted to say is a big hug to Steve from Dramatic Knits because his dog Gert died last week.
Oh no.
Yeah. She was 11, so.
Oh, Steve,
but
I'm
they,
so sorry.
They were not prepared. It was unexpected. And I'm really sorry. I know how it feels to lose a pet. So big hugs from us.
Sorry, Steve.
I know, it's like losing a family
member. It is
member.
Losing a family member. I've lost many animals. And
yeah,
it
so,
is losing a family member. So.
Shouts out to you, Steve, and to your leading man. I hope you feel better. Yeah. And take care of yourselves. And I think that's all I have.
Yeah, I don't have much gossip and innuendo because I pretty much said it. My crushes and heartbreaks, stuff in my shoulder really hurts. twinges every now and again. I guess that's it then.
I think that's it.
So we'll see you next week in one way or form.
One way or another.
Maybe I'll have my boys record with me.
We can figure it out.
We'll figure it out. Some way or another, you'll see something from us.
Somebody will have something next week.
So, thanks for watching us. If you're a new viewer, thanks for checking us out. Returning viewers, thanks for coming back each week. We appreciate it. And I missed you guys last week. Thanks for everyone who said they missed me.
And thanks for everybody who PM'd about anxiety disorder. It's good to get the information out there. So...
On that note, have a good week.
Knit with heart. Bye, everybody.
Bye.